Thing from the basement of La Penta. It's WICR.
Hello, Iona College. Welcome back to the WICR Morning Show. We are on our final segment, and it's been a very interesting morning. Yeah, it has. We just finished our interview with Yvonne Wenger. I think it went pretty well. I mean, you could definitely tell that she was sticking by her journalistic principles, being very objective with her answers, sticking by what she wrote, just reporting the facts. So let's go to Ian Sachs, one of our prominent writers of the Ionian. He stands by all that journalistic stuff too. But Ian, the thing I like about you is you're not afraid to tell your opinion. Now, Ian, talk about that kind of that line between being objective and stating the facts. I mean, when does it get to a point where you're kind of crossing that line?
Ian's so journalistic, he will ask a question she doesn't know the answer.
Well, yeah, I want to really test them and make sure that they know their stuff.
Stick to your story.
But you see, that's the kind of thing I want to see. I mean, I don't want the vanilla things. I want them grilling.
I want peanut butter ice cream. You can't have too much peanut butter, Joe. It gives me hives. All right?
Okay.
So no peanut butter.
Actually,
I love peanut butter. But I can't. I used to eat it off the spoon when I was a child. And, well, now I don't do that anymore.
You're a big boy now.
Because I'm an adult.
You're a big boy now,
I can make food. I wasn't allowed to use the stove, as you can imagine.
I'm still not allowed to use the stove, so...
That's probably a good idea. All your jerseys would leak onto the stove and you'd be on fire four times a week.
He would take them off because they might...
Oh, of course.
Yeah, do you take off your jerseys to eat dinner? You do.
Of course.
I knew it.
It's funny. People always ask me that question. We're like, well, what do you do? How do you keep your jersey so clean if you're eating all the time? Like, I take
them
off.
He wears them for 20 minutes a day, and then he takes it off.
People look at me like I'm crazy, but you know what?
No, it's true.
You've got to do what you've got to do to protect the pristine condition of the jersey.
Preserve the
stuff. It's all about preserving the stuff. When I eat, when I eat at school, obviously you can't take it off. People are like, who's that nut job over there?
You could.
You could. But I try to keep...
I would suggest that you do.
Yeah.
That's just me.
I would, but, you know, there's people who probably think I'm nuts already.
But you already think you're nuts, Joe.
I'm not going to do it. Because
I used to think you were crazy, but now I can
see
you're nuts.
I keep a level of separation. You know, I like to keep, like, this wide zone. It's measured out with a ruler and everything like that.
Is it called keeping your clothes on?
It is.
All right. That's a solid zone. I like that zone.
Man. Joe's definitely the type that stands to eat and hunches over the table so that nothing will spill.
I am definitely hunching over the table to make sure nothing spills. I mean, especially... No sauces at all.
Just plain grease.
I learned my lesson a long time ago. I still have nightmares about it. I wake up...
What was the worst mishap you've ever had with a jersey?
Okay, the worst mishap, and of course, I remember it like it was yesterday, you know. I still wake up sometimes and I have nightmares about it. I was wearing my Matt Ryan Atlanta Falcons white away jersey. I think it was I was in ninth grade, and in our high school cafeteria, there was a hot sauce pump. I would also always go and get
Where
hot sauce.
Where did you go to school?
Rye High School.
Next to a Tabasco factory?
So I go up, and then nothing's coming out. So I'm getting upset. I'm like, I want my hot sauce.
Don't lay down underneath it and pump it on yourself.
Oh, no. You're going to hear what's going to happen. So I push it a little bit harder than normal, and it just squirts, and I get it, and it hits the corner.
No.
It was like trauma. I was traumatized.
I can imagine Joe dropping to his knees in front of the hot sauce. No.
It was one of the worst things that ever happened.
Well, think about it this way. The Falcons have red.
Yeah, why didn't you just wear the red jersey?
It was the white one, though, so...
No, but red is one of their colors, so you're just adding to their color scheme.
Yeah, it could have been just like a
patch.
Yeah.
And here's the worst thing. I didn't learn from this because a couple weeks later, I was wearing my Joseph Addai Colts white away jersey.
Who gets a Joseph Addai jersey? That's a question that needs to be answered.
Joseph Addai was my guy.
Joseph Addai was like a top running back
for three minutes
in the NFL. And the Colts were like, we have Peyton Manning. What are you doing? And then he stopped and went away forever.
You know why Joe has a Joseph Addai jersey? Because he's Jersey Joe. Yeah.
Exactly. There's people who... So one time a kid saw me with a Pierre Thomas jersey on. I was like, I've never seen anybody who's had a Pierre Thomas jersey.
I would follow you. Here's the deal. Joe, I will follow you around.
Okay.
For a month. For 31 days. I will wake up...
That's a long month.
With you. I will go to sleep next to you.
Okay.
I will be your personal assistant.
Okay.
Of everything that you need. I will do your homework. I will pump your hot sauce. I will do whatever you want. If you give me the amount of money that you spend on 1 year's worth of jerseys.
That's fair. You know, it's funny because when I get home later, I got to buy another jersey. Manchester City long sleeve 2014-15 home kit.
That can't be cheap.
Oh, no, it's not. But you know what?
Do you work, Joe?
Do I work? Work's a loose term.
Must be nice to meet Joe. I'm feeling a little chilly. I'm going to go home and buy myself a Man City long sleever. So that way I can take care of myself in the winter and in the summer.
Man, this conversation really, I mean, we started it off with
Do
wanted
you, like,
to
rake leaves or something?
Well, you know, Joe, you asked about our journalistic practices.
This is our journalistic
exactly.
practice.
Yeah, exactly.
Kenny was like saying we got to grow them. That's exactly what
we're
doing.
That's where we went.
Hey,
that's
I like it. You know, this is the kind of interview that we want.
I think
we
you need more shoes. I think you need more shoes.
That's a good point.
I can be honest with you, Joe.
Here's the problem.
You're wearing black black and red, and you've got a blue and red going, and you know
that's a problem.
You're clashing, Joe.
I am clashing.
You're clashing.
The problem with that is every time people always tell me that. But the problem is whenever I go to buy a new pair of shoes, I got to get another jersey instead. So it's a constant battle. It is. It's a daily grind. A daily battle.
It's a snowball effect.
A snowball effect. Yeah.
Yeah, Roger.
Roger.
Mr. Goodell. You're just learning about it now, Joe. When you break your watch, you tell your mom.
So you know what, Joe? I have a question for you. Did you ever have an incident with hot sauce in a jersey?
With hot sauce in a jersey? You know, Ian, a couple minutes ago, we actually addressed that, so I don't know. Maybe,
really?
Maybe check your facts.
Wait, did you get the video of that before that you suspended the jersey?
The video of that?
Or are you lying?
Yeah.
Are you lying?
Am I lying?
Are you lying? Joe, you need to quit.
You know, let's get a private investigator to do to search this out. Armand Madeo. I'm going to call him up after the show. He'll be our private investigator.
Did you get the video 5 months ago and just found out
and
about
then
it now?
Just talk about it?
Look, this is turning into a witch hunt on the morning show, all right? Turning into a witch hunt on the morning. And it's funny, Ken, you were talking about watches. I actually wanted to talk about the Apple Watch here on this segment, but I guess we'll have to save that for another day. I guess we'll have to save that for another day.
You know what? You could probably buy an Apple Watch right now if you wanted to.
No.
Yup.
No.
You probably could, Joe.
For an Apple Watch, I could buy 3 Manchester
City
jerseys.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. He's got the money. You know
no,
he does.
No, I don't
he doesn't have to rake any leaves for that.
I don't have the money for it. I'm just very blessed and lucky to have a lot of people who are very supportive of me. I'll say that.
Yeah.
Very,
my parents are
very
great, too. Woo, mom and dad.
You know what, though? It's a business expense. It is. At the end of the day, it's a market. It's a marketing promotion. I'm marketing Jersey Joe. That's what it is. It's
trademark,
a
Jersey Joe.
What he's marketing is other people.
Yes, that is true, Joe.
That is
You're
true.
You're making more
you know,
money for them than you are for yourself,
That's the good
Joe.
Thing about soccer jerseys is there's no name on the back.
Yeah, it's just the ad that's on the front.
That's true. You know, I've promoted a lot more airlines than I've ever flown in or ever intend to fly on. I'm never planning to fly Emirates or Etihad Airways, so...
Well, you should now, I guess.
Yeah, I guess. I mean, I'm giving them free promotions,
You might as well.
Well,
I don't know.
Actually, you're paying them to promote them. Just want to clear that up with you. Before you buy the long sleeve, short sleeve, three-quarter sleeve, one-quarter sleeve, tank top, long pant, short pant, capri, boots, cleats...
He's got the whole set.
Well, actually, you know what? I still don't have the away one. I have the powder blues. I still got to get the away one. So
are any of them knockoffs, Joe?
Any
Be
of them
knockoffs? With me.
Here's the thing. Some.
Do you have a knockoff?
Don't I do?
Joe, answer the question.
I do.
Do you have a knockoff?
I'm. You know what? I'm an honesty broker. I'm all about telling honesty on the morning show.
Joe, can you hear me up there on top of your ivory tower? How's the weather?
Man. I'm going to look really bad in this interview. People are going to watch this and like, man, I can't stand that guy. Why am I listening to this show? Put those guys on.
Okay, so which ones you knock off?
A couple. I mean, there's some that they don't make anymore. So when they don't make it anymore, I got to do whatever I can to get it. So.
Well, if they don't make it anymore, I don't want it.
It's true.
You know, kind of like the old Ford Pinto. They don't make it anymore for a reason, Joe. Okay, killed a lot of people. It's also the reason I wouldn't buy an O.J. Simpson jersey.
No, I do not have.
Yeah, I actually have three of those.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Get me out of here. Get me out.
Ian, do you really have one?
No.
Okay. Well, you know what? Before we get any further into this, let's end the morning show here. When we come back, Ken and Spring will be on the morning show tomorrow.
Yeah.
That should be a lot of fun. I will be back on the morning show Wednesday with Ken and our producer Armand Madeo.
Oh, boy.
And I'm just going to put it out there now. I'll say it if no one else will. Godzilla, the new movie, is American cinema. I will explain on Wednesday's morning show.
I mean,
thank you.
You're right. It is American cinema, but that's also why nobody likes American cinema.
You see, why couldn't we just end it when I said thank you?
Well, because I don't want you to have the final word. Who produces tomorrow?
Who produces tomorrow? I think that's up to you.
Really? We don't have a Tuesdayer?
We do not have
a Tuesday. I thought we had a Tuesday. All right, let's go.
Well, yeah, before they don't think we know what we're doing
here. Wait, is
here,
it Brian?
It is Brian.
Brian Walsh.
Brian Walsh.
Brian Walsh.
Great on the radio voice. Stay tuned
he
for him.
He does have a great radio voice. Joe, I'm not going to let you go that easy.
Okay.
I'm not going to let you go that easy, Joe.
Well, you know, we've got
you're
people in here.
You're going to have to kick me off, Joe.
See, here's the easy thing is you've got this button right here, so I can do it. So thank you, everyone, for tuning in. Ian, thank you for joining us, and this has been a great morning show. A lot of fun. Thank you.
Thank you, Joe. I'll be back with you guys next week.
You got it. Yeah, thanks, Ken.
Oh, there he is.